about Vibhava Tanha. The original meaning of Vibhava is annihilation for non-existence. Therefore, Vibhava Tanha means thirst for non-existence, the desire to or aspiration to get rid of existence. There is, however, a variant I have heard of in interpreting this term, namely as a desire to get rid of a situation. For instance, an abbot desires to get rid of his position or of the monastery, sort of escapism. Or an adolescent desires to get rid of his parents or of his body, but without desiring non-existence directly. In this sense, Vibhava Tanha would mean a thirst for anyata bhava, for becoming different, for otherwiseness. Would you agree?
All that I have explained. Now, wait a minute. Existence of whom? Of a self, isn't it? That is the point which the Westerners can't take in. They are afraid of this word annihilation. I said there is nothing to annihilate when you come to the anatta. So the question of bhava vibhava, in the interpretation of people who have clinging on to the self, existence or the continuation of self, and the opposite is destruction of self. About the Arahant, it is said, Neva Atankati Bhavaeva Vibhava. The Arahant position is neither he cares for existence. Yeah, then alone I have also pointed out in the, I think it is in the about the Theragata, that verse, Adhimutta Theragata, then the bandits came to kill Adhimutta Thera, Vasan Arahant. That verse I have heard it. One Namma Marlada, you can kill me if you like. What happens is this. Sankhara vibhavishanti. Tathata paridevana. If you kill me, what happens is sankhara get destroyed. You see? So the story in when it is viewed according to the Buddha's question of sankhara. That is why sabba sankhara samatha. No question of self. It's a very deep point. It's the Westerners can. Many have addressed this question. All the big preachers, they go on saying, this is not annihilation. Why you? You see, that fear comes only to those who cling on to this. I have pointed their entrance with them clearly. Read it again and again. The fever, mana, pucha, and all those things. So, these are false, I mean, say, it's a false fear. If you really understand what it is. No self exists to be destroyed. But to continue. The whole sankhara. This, that I have further explained. Avijja pachya sankhara. Asopa. The particular word. Siddhi. I should say serious interpretation into free life. I pointed out with the just cinema thing. In the darkness of ignorance. Imagine a cinema and all. Firstly, you enter the hall, then darkness comes, then all your attention is on the screen, then you enjoy it, suddenly light comes. So similarly, avijja paccaya sankhara, and the sankhara, the preparations, go on between nāma-rūpa and viññāna. Nāma-rūpa is the screen, viññāna is the spectator. Try to understand that. So this goes on the darkness of avijja. So that this light of wisdom comes, not through the intellectual distinct, but that is a very deep point which people can't understand. Something that happens. I have explained it for you, before for them. Read up my Samyutta Nikaya anthology, Rose Justice Sister's interpretation. Only recently I translated Concept and Reality, Magic of the Mind. I have helped you before my own people. This especially the so far people could not understand commentator theory. Vinyanam anidarsanam anantam sabbato bhava. Sabbato bhava they could not understand. I made fun of the course of interpretation before the ground. Sabbato papa. Papa. Absurd. they could not understand. So then you call it Mahayana also, look at all their beautifully. The Nagarjuna and other certain things. So Bhaswaram, Kalpanya, Vimuktam. The Vimukta mind, eh? So Bhaswaram. So Bhaswaram. It is not, I have also pointed out, when people interpret the Buddha saying that there are four clusters, four alokas, they think Panya aloka is just absurd, there is something outside there. Say, what are they? Sandhaprabha, Suryaprabha, Abhyaprabha, Panyaprabha. They say Panyaprabha is something that the Buddha used just on this word. I say, that is the light in which other lights fade. The 15th sermon, Parasana Deshana, and Sivani, Amutupamava Yadvani. In the 15th sermon, you have it in the English. 15th Nibbana sermon is very, just as in the 15th Parisambha sermon, where I waxed poetic. I said, suddenly, before the Guhamde, I became poetic, so the game I did too. Sankaya has this. First of all, in the evening, you get twilight. Say, Sankaya has this, Tarupaya Adinimakot. After the stars come up, he sees something, at least to some degree. Then the moon comes. The stars say that for the moon. Then you see this. Then I said, that's poetic. And I will be up and the Thomas Parajan is a super valuable. Then what happens? Thank God. Especially after the full moon. You see the moon only this in the moon. That color fades. So, this fading away goes. When Panya light comes, the whole world fades away. Anishunya, that is Shunyata. Salayata Nirodha. The entire six and eight. That is the Nibbana here and now. I have pointed out the Mahaparinibbana Sutta Buddha says, the monks. Once I was meditating in the class house, and it when it was raining, peaks of thunder and lightning, four bulls and two farmers were killed. I didn't know anything. When I came out and I asked, they said, what happened? But did you see? No. Were you sleeping? No. Were you in contact? With the contact, I made it. He was in the palace. So this aspect of the Dhamma is going down now. That is what I started with for the intellectuals whoever you are. So that these things, if you have the correct sansaric maturity, you get it in a jiffy. Don't expect, not everyone is born with the silver spoon. We have to make a style. The time comes. Your other knowledge is see, rise and fall, and then the other thing. Then you see it.
What more? There is another question. Once I saw the stimulus for mutual dependence of Vijnana and Nama Rupa. Once I myself I found a simile for the mutual dependence of Vijnana and Nama Rupa.
Yeah.
It is an electric device, it is called movement detector, maybe you know. And in the night it lights up only when it detects the movement. So you can have it in front of your kuti. If a dog comes, it will light up. So it came into my mind, if the movement is the rupa, the light is vijnana, they depend on each other. If no movement, no light. Now, once I told about this Venerable Dhammajiva, and I said, but unless the detector, the movement detector is broken, he is in a kind of a standby. There is electric power in the wire. But it doesn't work unless a rupa comes, a movement. So is there in Pali a word for this potential consciousness?
Not potential. I tell you first.
Yes.
The mutual dependence of vijnana, rupa, is beautifully explained by the simile of the two, which is the cover.
Yeah.
This. So vijnana is dependent on nama rupa, nama rupa. That is what we started with. This goes on through samsara. Jnana patya nama rupa nama rupa. So, other similes are useless. Because the word paticca is very deep. Paticca is very deep. If I may go deep into the etymology of, as I do often. The root E has two meanings. One meaning is to know, the other is to go. Now, what is against each other? So, imagine now situation. Here, it wants to go here, go. Now this is the crux. They are all jnana patya nama rupa nama rupa patya jnana. You are in a fix. So, until you put an end to nama rupa. Other, of course, I myself use some electronic similes or other things. Provided they are, they prove the point, not otherwise. Not every gadget in the world as I was this. But not perhaps the one you are talking about, because in the nama rupa definition of the definition I gave, rupa is not something all by itself. And you, rupa is understood through nama, vedana, sanya, chetana, bhakti, manasikara. I used a new simile, which you get in the English. I intoxicated them to this name. At your fingertips. Haven't you read? Get it from where you are? Of course it is not in the channel. I compared it to the five. People start with thakta. All these big creatures, they say thakta comes before Vedana. I say Vedana comes. In this context. Normally. Because I say, feeling is delicate, the small but mysterious, smaller the bugger, bigger the rascal, aren't you? Then this is the fellow, Vedana, first song. Then, Sanya, the ring finger. Perception is the ring finger. Both notorious, both, well known and notorious, then the middle finger, that is chetana. Vedana, sanya, chetana. I say give that. With which you call the waiter, the silent meeting. Chetana. Then, vedana, sanya, chetana, tasya. Tasya is the index finger. Closest to the thumb. The thumb, the dictionary explains in it, standing apart, but approachable to the rest. Manasikara. Manasikara sambha. This hatha includes mental pasta also. Mind contact. Where it goes deeper, I told you. Manopubbangama dhamma has not been explained all these years, all these centuries. The first two verses of Dhammapada. I had to interpret them. That is why I have great sangvega. what have we, what these funks have been doing all this time? For centuries. Mano Pubbam Dhamma Dhamma. Mano and Dhamma. They think it is only about Kusala Kusala Kusala. That is not it. This is an exam. Mano Pubbam Dhamma Dhamma. Mano Sitta. Mano Maya. That is all Dhamma. All things, so-called whatever things. We have mind as the forum. Mano Sitta. Mind is the chief. Mano Maya. They have mind. Mind. So, that is where Dhammapada starts with. The rest follows as much as possible.
And the last one is when an embryo is in the womb, and as the Buddha mentioned in Mahanidana Sutta, consciousness has not slipped out, it is alive. Then in the embryo are some subtle feelings, perception, it is dreaming, and but no awareness, of course. Now, in Western terms, we call this a subconscious state or a slumber. What would it be in Pali? Is this the Bhavanga thought or what was it?
Forget this Bhavanga and the Abhidharma test. We have made the worst thing. I didn't use the word Abhidharma test because these people will come and they go on counting pitches. This Bhavanga question is utterly out of the system. Vijnana, that has been clearly explained. Apart from the six, no Vijnana by itself, that's fire. No abstract fire, you know. Whatever fire that takes in, this is a paper fire, cloth fire, chaff fire. Fire gets the name by what it takes hold of. There is no similarity. We don't go with this self-notioned Western psychologist. They are babies. They go by the psychiatrist. Don't read them, if I say this. When the Buddha is there, this absurd psychiatrist and so on.
And Mahansi, do you then think that Bhavanga Sutta is mistaken for kind of a self?
Yes, he is.
Yes, mistaken
every
for
time is that. Bhavanga is Sutta. That Buddha says, you see, in the Vijnana Sutta, Sandhavati, this is Sutta. This is nothing to be called as a Bhavanga, as something interim. But in this drawing in, no identity. When you say a flux idea. So, Vijnana and Namrupa alternation. Jnana Patya Namrupa, Namrupa Patya Vijnana. It goes on like that. Try to take it. You may not take in everything. But at least, come out with all your questions. I can only direct you to the... Don't simply stop with conceptual and reality, the magic of dynamics. Fill up every word of what I have written. I have helped you all before my own people. All my first writings, concepts and reality, written when I was 30 years, 32, Magic of the Mind, in the same year, Sanyukta Anthology, Ideal Solitude, and then the rest came. Even my footnotes.
Step by step, because
it's
very difficult.
And I was going to tell about the scene too, about something strange, which I wanted to tell from my leader, because he published, he translated it to them, about 10-15 years ago. Mr. Mapa was the ambassador of Burma, Myanmar. When he went there, he took some copies of my scenes, translation of the Sutta, the time of the place. You know what happened? Those who were struck by that little book, Mr. Mapa made a request. They are asking for one of your youth robes. And I think I got one of my friends to air my list. So I wanted to tell them, though I did not, I have not gone to Burma. My robe is there. Ask Mr. Mahabhagyaji.
Simon said, if you criticize Abhidharma, don't they hate you in Burma?
Fine. No, they do not. No, that is now. They have gained, I told you. Not everybody. But this diehard, except diehard, really, many have understood. See, what happens was, they don't know that this great philosopher and very deep in Shunyata of Nagarjuna, people think it is wrong, very deep. He started, and that was the question that Shunyata Sarva Drishtina, Buddha has preached the discussion of all Drishtis. So, and he also told about this Prabhasara Sutta and like that. That is the, though we call it Mahayana and so on, early Madhyamika, as much that is Buddha. Well,